Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had major seismic activity on the 24th, following the critical planetary geometry on the 21st, 22nd. That was a convergence that I discussed in the previous update. One major earthquake occurred at the Kermadec Islands, and that was early on the 24th, and later on the same day, another magnitude 7 earthquake, 6.9 borderline 7 at Sumatra. Two major earthquakes on one day, that is a lot, but also the geometry on the 22nd was rather critical. On the SGI graph, we see a clustering of strong earthquakes around the time of the planetary geometry on the 22nd, and then following that geometry, the two major earthquakes. And the rule of thumb, as I explained more often, is that we add 2 days from the moment of the geometry, and then give or take 1 day, and that's exactly around the 24th. So let's have a look at the geometry that we're going to have in the coming days. On the 28th, 29th, we're going to have geometry again very similar to what we had on the 21st, 22nd. We have a convergence of critical geometry involving Mercury and Venus. If we look at the solar system, we see a conjunction with Venus, the Sun, and Saturn, and that will be on the 28th around 1900 hours. It's actually 1956 UTC. It is preceded and followed by 90 degree angles, right angles, also involving Venus. This is going to be critical. So let's have a look at those 90 degree angles. We have Venus with Mars and Uranus at 1842 on the 28th. And that will be followed by the planetary conjunction, which is very critical because Venus is again lining up with an outer planet. And then several hours later, and that will be at 8:02 UTC on the 29th. Another right angle, 90 degree angle, with Mercury, Venus and Jupiter. So this is going to be a critical convergence, and we could see strong to major seismic activity, most likely 29th, 30th, maybe May 1st. It could also be a little bit earlier. There may be a clustering again of stronger seismic activity around the time of this convergence of planetary geometry that would be around the 28th. And this could really start as early as the 27th, but the strongest seismic activity, this could be or could include a major seismic event that would probably be around the 29th, 30th. If we add 2 days from the 28th, we would end up on the 30th and then give or take 1 day. So 29th, 30th and the 1st of May are probably going to be most critical. We could again see a higher 6 to 7 magnitude, and in a worst case scenario, we could even see a magnitude 8 at that time. So let's have a look at the atmospheric fluctuations that we had since the 21st, that is since the previous update, and we had quite a lot of them. And two regions stand out, that is the Middle East, western part of Iran in particular, and also South America. So let's have a look. On the 21st, we had a region, the eastern part of Asia, primarily over China, just north of Myanmar, Bangladesh. I'm not sure if that fluctuation is still relevant, but I'm showing this to you anyway. And then the first marking the western part of Iran, Iraq, this actually between Iran and Turkey, that was also on the 21st, and to the south, the eastern part of Africa, where we can see some stronger seismic activity occasionally. And then on the 22nd, we had South America, Chile primarily, but also the northern mid-Atlantic ridge. And that's the first. Then also on the 22nd, again, western part of Iran. And that is marking a little bit of the Arabian plate as well, most likely the eastern part. But if you are around the Arabian plate, be on extra alert in the final days of April, just in case. Then on the 23rd, some parts over the West Pacific, including Sumatra, where a day later the major earthquake occurred. Then on the 24th, again, the western part of Iran. This is the third time. So we could really see some seismic increase there. How much? magnitude 6, maybe just higher, 5 magnitude. It could also be magnitude 6, and in a worst case scenario, it could even reach the low 7 magnitude range. There's no way to know the exact magnitude, because that depends on the condition of Earth's crust, the amount of stress in Earth's crust, and we cannot measure that. So there's no way to determine exact magnitude. There is also no way to determine the exact location, because we use atmospheric fluctuations, which are in the atmosphere, so we cannot isolate exact locations. The atmospheric fluctuations really mark approximations. And again, to the south, also towards Africa, it could also be in the northwestern part of the Indian Ocean. Finally, this morning, a significant fluctuation, again marking South America. We see Chile again, and to the north, the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, North Mid-Atlantic Ridge, that also includes the Azores Cape St. Vincent Ridge between the Azores and Portugal. And that fault has some history. In 1755, a magnitude 9 earthquake occurred off the coast of Portugal, which was very devastating. I do not expect a magnitude 9 earthquake or close to something like that in the coming days, but a magnitude 7 earthquake is definitely possible. The last time that that occurred along that ridge was in the 1970s, about 47 years ago. So it seems that this fault is due for at least a major earthquake, and that could definitely happen in the final days of April. Then also to the South Sandwich Islands is also a candidate. A magnitude 7 earthquake, a major earthquake, occurs there on average about every 2 years. The last time that this happened was in August 2021. So we are approaching the time that another major earthquake is going to happen there, which probably will not affect human life or urban areas, of course. So let's hope that if large earthquakes are going to occur, it happens in a remote area, but we have seen the two regions in the Middle East. That stands out because we had significant fluctuations in the last couple of days over that area. And also South America also seems to be in the crosshairs. Check out the website for the latest updates. On the main page, we have the forecast and the magnitude probability. And there's also a link just below the forecast where you can check out the latest atmospheric fluctuations. This is the update for now. This is the information that we have so far. Stay safe. Until next time.